Welcome to the Basilica of the Sacred Heart. Please stand and join in singing our opening hymn, Holy God, We Praise Thy Name.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
May the Lord, whose praises are sung by the angels and saints, be with all of you.
And with your spirit.
Please be seated. Bishop Jenky, on behalf of everyone here present this evening, I want to thank you for coming from Peoria to preside at the blessing of this magnificent Murdy family organ. As my predecessor for some 20 years as rector of the Basilica, I know how much you have looked forward to this day. I wish also to thank Holy Cross Father Richard Warner, who as director of campus ministry at the time, was very supportive of our efforts to secure a pipe organ worthy of this basilica, the mother church of the Congregation of Holy Cross in North America. This project could never have been completed without the leadership of the director of music of the basilica at the time, Dr. Gail Walton. Unfortunately, she did not live to see this day, having entered eternal life almost 7 years ago this coming February. She is with us, however, in spirit, rejoicing in this night. Thanks, of course, to Paul Fritz and his associates in Tacoma, Washington, who, working closely with the Basilica Organ Committee, designed and built this magnificent organ. I cannot adequately thank Dr. Andrew McShane, the Basilica's Director of Music, for overseeing all the many details involved in the installation of the organ here in the Basilica. And lastly, and most especially, I want to express my sincerest gratitude to Wayne and Diana Murdy and their family for their very generous benefaction of this new Fritz organ. I cannot thank you enough for making this dream, 10 years in the making, come true this night. If Wayne and Diana, if you could come forward, I have a small gift as a token of our deepest appreciation of your gift, not only to the Congregation of Holy Cross, but also to the University of Notre Dame.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, before whose throne trumpets sound and saints and angels sing the songs of Moses and the Lamb, accept this instrument which we offer to your glory and for the worship of your holy temple, that with the voice of music we may proclaim your praise and tell it abroad, and grant that in this generation and in those that are to come, its voice may continually call your people to praise and worship. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the second book of Chronicles. Then Solomon assembled the elders of Israel and all the heads of the tribes, the leaders of the ancestral houses of the people of Israel in Jerusalem, to bring up the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord out of the city of David, which is Zion. And all the Israelites assembled before the king at the festival that is in the seventh month. And all the elders of Israel came, and the Levites carried the ark. So they brought up the ark, the tent of meeting, and all the holy vessels that were in the tent. The priests and the Levites brought them up. Now when the priests came out of the holy place, for all the priests who were present had sanctified themselves without regard to their divisions, all the Levitical singers, Asaph, Heman, and Jeduthun, their sons and kindred, arrayed in fine linen, with cymbals, harps, and lyres, stood east of the altar with 120 priests who were trumpeters. It was the duty of the trumpeters and singers to make themselves heard in unison in praise and thanksgiving to the Lord. And when the song was raised with trumpets and cymbals and other musical instruments, in praise to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. The house of the Lord, was filled with a cloud, so that the priests could not stand to minister because of the cloud. For the glory of the Lord filled the house of God. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Lord God, your beauty is ancient yet ever new. Your wisdom guides the world in right order, and your goodness gives the world its variety and splendor. The choirs of angels join together to offer their praise by obeying your commands. The galaxies sing your praises by the pattern of their movement that follows your laws. The voices of the redeemed join in a chorus of praise to your holiness as they sing to you in mind and heart. We, your people, joyously gathered in this basilica, wish to join our voices to the universal hymn of praise, so that our song may rise more worthily to your praise. We present this organ for your blessing, to express our prayer and praise in melodies that are pleasing to you. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Sacred instrument, intone the praises of God, our Creator and Father. Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy dwelling. Sacred instrument, you will celebrate Jesus our Lord, dead and risen for us.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy dwelling.
Sacred instrument, you will sing of the Holy Spirit, whose breath animates our lives.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy dwelling.
Sacred instrument, you will carry our songs and our supplications to Mary, the Mother of Jesus.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy
instrument, you will fill the assembly of the people with gratitude to Christ.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy dwelling.
Sacred instrument, you will bring the comfort of faith to those who sorrow.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy dwelling.
Sacred instrument, you will sustain the prayer of believers.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy dwelling.
Sacred instrument, you will proclaim the glory of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Praise the Lord, praise God in His holy
dwelling. My sisters and brothers, immediately following our prayer together, everyone is invited to stay for the dedicatory recital to be played by Craig Cramer, professor of organ here at the University of Notre Dame.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. The Lord is worthy of all praise. May he give you the gift of striving to sing a new song to him with your voices, your hearts, and your lives, so that one day you may sing that song in heaven forever and ever.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.